Classic collector cars have always been desirable because of their sleek body designs and what's hidden under the hood. But older cars such as this 1972 Ferrari 365 GTC4 are desirable because of the story that goes with it. This has a very unique story. It's a one-owner car from new. The original owner bought the car in 1974 from the factory and still owns it today. Not only does it have the tail to go with it, but it also has all the corroborating paperwork. So it has the original bill of sale, the original correspondence between the factory and the buyer, so letters back and forth between the two, and it has the original warranty card. So the books and tools for these cars, the books came with a warranty card with the original owner printed on it. And most of those things, because the car is 48 years old, a lot of time they disappear throughout the years, but this one still has all the paperwork, which is pretty much unbelievable in a car like this. I've never seen it before. It's the only car I've found that still has all that paperwork. This car is not only unique because of the paperwork and the one owner history, but it also has some options that you don't really find on other C4s. For example, this car, because the C4s were built from 1971 to 1972, they had a very short production run, and there was only 505 cars built. However, the gas crisis hit in 1973, making these cars very hard to sell. So in 1974, when a buyer for this particular car came around the factory, they had a few C4s left, and they would take whatever they had and make do whatever they had to do to sell it to the buyer. So this was a Euro model car originally, but the buyer was US based. So they had to make it a US car. So they did some modifications, like they put the US side markers on there. On Euro cars, they're the little dots. On US, they're the big rectangles. And the engine has some modifications that I'll talk about in a little bit. But what makes it a Euro car, if you initially look at it, is the seats. So on US cars, they were all leather seats. And on this car, on Euro cars, they had cloth inserts to match the exterior. So this has the red exterior with the tan seats and the red cloth inserts to match. It also has red cloth inserts on the door panels. And that is a very unique Euro thing. It also has two-point seat belts, and the US cars came with the three-point seat belts. So when you first look at it, you're kind of like, wait, is it a Euro, is it a US? Because the seats scream Euro and the side markers scream US. The Euro and US C4s had some variations in the engines. The US model C4s had some smog equipment that made them slightly less horsepower than the Euro model cars. So the US model had, they had heat shields around the headers that would, in theory, make the headers burn hotter and make the exhaust fumes burn hotter, which would burn off more of the fumes. And it was a nice theory. It was all part of a scheme to try and conform to the US EPA regulations. They also have all the smog equipment on the car. And since this car is a 1972, it doesn't need smog anymore. So a lot of times people would take that stuff off and kind of just throw it away. So it's very rare to find still on a car. So this car would be a great candidate for like FCA events, because it's one of those things that wins you extra points because you never see it anymore. Another thing about the C4, the engines, all the cars, Euro or US model, they have the 4.4 liter Colombo V12 engines. And what's interesting is Ferrari's numbering system. So on, for instance, a Boxer, a 512, it's 5 liter V12. Whereas on the 365, whether it's Daytonas or C4s, it stands for 365 cc's per cylinder times 12 cylinders is roughly 4,400 or 4.4 liter. And then the GT is Grand Touring. Now, this car is based off the Daytona with a slightly longer chassis to accommodate the back seats. So a Daytona is GTB, which the B stands for Berlinetta. And this car, GTC, the C stands for coupe. Now, both technically mean hardtop, but Berlinetta also means hardtop two-seater, and a coupe means hardtop four-seater. So the numbering systems on Ferraris can get a bit confusing, but I find them quite interesting to learn because it dictates what the car is and all the little details about it. The four in GTC4 stands for four cams. So this car is a grand touring coupe with four cams. Now other V12 Colombo engines were two cams, so this one you can clearly see designated in its name that it's a four cam engine. On 48-year-old cars, they're gonna need some work throughout the years. And this car has been fully restored. We have hundreds of photos of the restoration, and you can see how thorough of a job that was done on this car. Everything from suspension, brakes, the body, the interior, everything's been sorted through. There's even photos of things like the door handles and the switches and everything being taken out, taken apart, redone, just so they're like they were when they first rolled out of the factory in 1972. And it's the level of restoration that really matters on these cars, because sometimes people will kind of throw paint a coat on it and do the cosmetics and try and make it look nice, but they don't drive well. Or they'll drive really nice, but have a lot of cosmetic flaws. This car has the best of both worlds, where everything was taken apart and sorted, and it drives like a dream. It really drives like a new car. When you first get in an old car, 70s car, something like that, and you're used to driving modern cars, it's quite the experience because things are a little more touchy and take a little more work to get going. But this one, you literally turn the key and you go, and it's a breeze, which makes the driving experience of an old car so much nicer because you're not really working at it too hard. And C4s have always been one of my favorite cars because Dinos have a sleeker body design, but C4s, which are around the same time period, are more horsepower and faster and more powerful cars. Now Daytonas, which were the predecessor to this, may have more horsepower, but the C4s have more torque, and they all came with power steering, making them a lot easier to maneuver in tight spots and parking spaces and our showroom and places like that. So it's just overall a very luxurious driving experience. Old cars like this tend to be a little touchy. They have personalities and can be, you know, a little tricky to drive sometimes, but this one, it shifts like a dream. It has really touchy but good brakes, which you want in a powerful car like this. Everything works well. The steering is nice and tight and responsive. Even for a bigger car like this, it's nimble. And it feels like driving on a cloud, but not a big heavy cloud. It's a nice soft cloud that, you know, maneuvers well. Just overall, the driving, I have loved the chance to drive this car because it does everything right. It's everything you could want in a classic Ferrari. I mean, you know, there's only so much you can ask for from a 50-year-old car. And you do expect a lot in the Ferraris just because of the name and all that. But it does everything right, and with a V12, it has all the power in the world. Hope you guys enjoyed watching a little in-depth detail on the history of this car and what makes it so unique. If you liked the video, please subscribe to our channel, hit like, and stay tuned because we have so many cars to do videos on. I can't wait to show you what's coming up next.